Hello, this is Kathleen Minetti doing a little video for some of my friends on the Beginners Tatting group on Facebook and for Georgia Site's online Beginners Tatting class. We'll be working on shuttle tatting. I was asked to make this specific video to help those of you who are left-handed, but I thought I would make it a little comprehensive since what we're going to do is simply set up, wind a shuttle set up to tat. That's all that we're going to do in this video. Okay, so for a right-handed person, you want to wind your shuttle so that the thread, I like to use my points up and hold them this way, the thread should fall out the back of your shuttle and naturally into your grip. Do you see what I'm talking about here? When I hold the shuttle this way with what I consider the top up, the thread is wound counterclockwise. And when I pick it up, it sits naturally in my hand with the thread running down through my fingers. If you are left-handed, you're going to want to wind your shuttle clockwise so that the same thing will be true for you. Here's the point. You can see when I put this in my hand in the same position how the thread falls naturally down across my fingers. If you try to work with your shuttle wound the other way, sometimes it's going to kind of fight you and you're going to have to reach for it. So you really want it to fall out of the shuttle in a way that is comfortable for you. Okay, it doesn't matter whether it's right clockwise or anti-clockwise. The key is when you're holding your shuttle to work with it, the thread should fall easily and comfortably right into that crease there. That will help as you're making your stitches. Okay, we're going to start with setting up to tat a chain. First I'll do right-handed, then I'll do left-handed. Okay, so here's my right-handed wound. I have my two different colors so you can see what I'm doing. You can see that I've tatted a little bit of chain first. I'm grabbing the place where I want to start the tatting, right between my thumb and forefinger. I'm going to wind this chain thread around my hand. And then for me, my circulation gets cut off if I do this. That's the traditional method, is to wind it several times around your little finger. It doesn't work for me, so I get a little fancy. I do a little bit of a figure eight. I found that if I put just one little extra twist, this is not important. What's important is that you have a space to work between these fingers and that you have a way to keep it tight enough while you're working that it won't fall off your hand when you loosen your fingers. Next, you pull your shuttle thread over, place that in your fingers, wrap your hands around here. For the modern double stitch, we do what we call the first half. Is you've got the thread falling down your hand, you're going to wrap it over the back of your fingers, you're going to attack the thread with the shuttle sliding underneath it, and just slide it. You don't let go of the shuttle, just slide it off the back end of the shuttle, back under the shuttle, and you notice you've got this loop over your hand, so you're going to tie a knot. Do you see the knot that's forming there? Well, now I'm going to relax those fingers and I'm going to pull this one tight. As I open those left hand fingers up again in my right hand tatting, you can see I have transferred the knot. I'm going to do the second half. Again, don't let go of your shuttle, just slide it across the bottom, up over the back end. And you notice, I'm going to undo this, you notice what have I got a grip on down here? That thread. Okay, so the loop is now below. Slide it across the bottom, up across the top, transfer. I'm pulling up on this so that you can see my hands. I'm going to keep this nice and tight. Open this up, pull it over, voila, a double stitch. Let's see if I can do this with my left hand. Again, I got a little bit of tatting here. Let's go ahead and make another double stitch on this fuchsia chain. The place you want the stitch to fall goes between your thumb and forefinger. You wrap your chain thread around your fingers, wind it around your little finger, or do the figure eight thing, or whatever works for you. Again, it matters very little as long as it works. The trick is to be able to keep enough tension on your thread, enough control, that you can tighten and loosen this working space. This is my working space. Some people work back here. Other people like to hold their thread like this, as if they were crocheting. It doesn't work very well for me, so I'm going to go back to the way I know how to do it and that I'm comfortable with. Pick up your shuttle. Make sure your thread falls back. Wrap it around the back of your hand. Working in this space. Got to get my angles right so you can see what I'm doing here. Working in your space. Slide thread across the top. Off the back end. Slide it across the bottom. Pull the shuttle thread tight to transfer the stitch, and then you notice how I stretched out my fingers is how I get that stitch, and I pull this down towards me, not necessarily away, but more down towards me to move that stitch in here. Let's do the second half. Second half, I've got a grip on my thread. I'm going to let it stay down loose, slide across the bottom, off the end, across the top, relax the right hand, hold the left thread tight. As you open up your left or right hand fingers, you transfer your knot. And there's your double stitch. All right. Let's try setting up for a ring. We're going to do the stitches the same, but it's what we stitch onto that is going to change. Here's my right hand thread. All right. We're doing setting up to tat a ring. So this is the thing that's called reverse work. This is what I just did. I'm going to rotate it so that the tops of my stitches are facing down. Then I'm going to wrap the shuttle thread around my hand. And I'm going to pinch it back into the same spot where I want my first stitch to end up, right up under my thumb. That means I have to let out some thread here so that I have enough thread to wrap around my hand and be long enough to comfortably work. Once again, first stitch over the top, off the end, over the bottom. Pull the shuttle thread tight while you relax the ball thread or ring thread, and then keep it tight and pull it a little bit towards you as you shift your stitch into position. Once more, the second half. Across the bottom, over the top, keeping your grip on this loop so that you're actually tying a knot. Do you see the transfer there? There you go. And I have the first double stitch in my ring. Let's work on a left hand. So, I have just finished tatting that double stitch. I want to reverse work, let out some thread, wrap it around my left hand, back up into the pinch, give myself enough room to work. There's no getting away from this. You're going to be lengthening and shortening your thread on a regular basis. Okay, so I've got this wrapped around my hand. I'm ready for my first stitch. I'm going to go across the top, off the bottom, back across the bottom. Pull it into position. Second half, I've got a good grip on that loop. Slide the bottom across. Let's see if I can allow you to see what I'm doing there. There we go. And then up across the top. Relaxing the right hand while you pull the left hand taut. And then you open the fingers on the right hand again as you pull the shuttle thread to you. And you got your stitch. Let's do that again for you left-handed peoples. First half, the thread's on the back of your hand, across the top, off the bottom, across the bottom, tight shuttle, loose ball or ring thread. Once it's transferred, open those fingers up as you pull the shuttle towards you. Second half, bottom, top, transfer. Whoops, I let it get off my fingers. That's going to give me grief later, isn't it? Okay, so now I need to keep this tight so the transfer remains in place. Pull it towards there. Now, to see if you've done this right on a ring, it's really easy. You pull on the shuttle thread, your ring should get smaller, and if you pull on the thread as it comes out the bottom of your thumb and finger, you should be able to enlarge it. If you cannot do that, then you've got a stitch that hasn't transferred properly, and you won't be able to close your ring when you're done with this element. So there you go. I hope this is helpful for you, and let me know if I can do any other videos.